Hey guys, what's up? This is Vincent, and in this video, I'm going to do a quick Topaz Gigapixel AI review with some real-life photos that I took a few years ago in the Galapagos Islands. So right now I have Gigapixel AI in front of me, and I'm going to pull in two photos to see what the results are. Now let me just change this to single view. So here's the first photo, and I'm going to zoom out of a flower that I want to crop and upscale. The flower, I took it in the Galapagos Islands on San Cristobal Island. You'll notice here, there's no preview because I'm zoomed out, so I need to zoom back in. But before I do that, I'm just gonna crop it and give this image an okay crop. Let's take a look here. Anyways, regarding composition, that's not what I'm showing, so I'll just give a basic crop. I'll crop in, and still, it's not updated, so I'm going to zoom in to about 100%, and then I'm going to show you a side-by-side view and see how this flower or these two flowers look. So, on the right-hand panel, I'm upscaling by 4 times here. And here is the cropped image, the resolution just over 2000 pixels. And here's the upscale. So I'm upscaling to 4 times, which is pretty heavy, but just for demonstration purposes, it'll be fine. But the final file will be pretty big. But anyways, the AI model that I have is standard, but let me choose this here, the automatic, and Gigapixel AI is going to choose the best AI model. So right now it chose art and CG generated for a computer graphics. So you can see here the before and after image of this flower. So the flower looks really good. It is interesting that it selected art and CG. I personally would have gone with standard, it did give a slight improvement, but not as great as the art and CG. You can see the noise reduction in the updated or preview here, as well as a little bit of sharpening. But the photo does still look soft with the standard, but just because I'm assuming this was already a little bit blurry, so that's why standard didn't do a really good job. So I wouldn't choose high quality or low res. So let me just go back to art and CG. And yeah, you can see art and CG does a much better job, even though the labeling of the AI model is a little bit off. And I'm not gonna suppress noise or remove any blur, that looks fine. And let me see how it looks here when I zoom out. So you can only see a slight, you may not even be able to see it on the video, but from my screen here, you can see a slight improvement, as well as a little bit of noise reduction here in the background in the green. But you can really notice a difference when you zoom in here. You can see the noise reduction removed. Mostly it's luminous noise that I have here. So overall, like, Gigapixel AI did a really good job with the upscaling to 4 times after I cropped the image. Once again, most people are not going to upscale to something over 8,000 pixels unless you're doing printing. But yeah, it looks really good. Vibrant colors, there's detail in these whiskers, I guess you can say, of this flower. I'm not going to save the images just because I've already checked it. The images, when they output exactly the same, so it's fine. And this is a JPEG, by the way. Here's the file name. And now I'll go to the next photo. Let me just zoom out here before I go to the next photo. And this is a tortoise at the breeding center or the conservation center on San Cristobal Island in the Galapagos. And just like the previous photo, the preview is not updated until I zoom in a little bit, which I will do. And let me just crop it in first. That looks a little bit better. And automatically 4 times the scale is applied. You can scale it up to 6 times or even more, I believe. Let me see how much you can scale it up, actually. Let me see if I can put 10. See if it works. So it doesn't accept 10. Actually, maximum is 5.85, it says right there. So depending on the file size, it is limited to a certain amount of pixels. Let me put 5.85, and that still doesn't work. Let me try it again. Yeah, for some reason it's not working. Oh, now it works when I click on six times. So it looks like on the long end, you can only upscale to just over 20,000 or just under 21,000 pixels on the long edge. But let me just go back to four times right here. And let's zoom in on this tortoise. And let's go in on the face actually. See how well it does on this face. So let me see what AI model it'll select automatically by just toggling this on and off. So it clicks standard or chose standard, which I expected, which should be the normal for most photos that are taken with a digital camera. For old family photos that were taken with a film camera and you digitize it, you'll most likely want to use low res or very compressed. But let's go back to this tortoise. Let's see how it did. So you can see it's very pixelated, especially the background of the soil here, and the pixelation has been removed in the preview here. There's a lot of really good edge sharpening. Noise is not visible when I'm zoomed in here. Let me zoom out a little bit. So I do see, no, that's just a little bit of blur. There's not that much noise in this image. So let me scroll back in here. Yeah, so with Gigapixel AI, cropping and then enlarging the image to four times, it did a really good job on this giant tortoise. And it also did a pretty good job distinguishing the edges right here compared to the soil. So so upscaling is pretty difficult here because the soil and the tortoise have the same color, so it did a pretty good job. This material or rock material and debris here and these twigs, Gigapixel AI did a pretty good job of guessing what it should look like, and it definitely enhanced the image. So overall, just with the difficulty of these images that I upscaled, this image is much more harder to upscale, and Gigapixel AI did a really good job just with the standard. And I wonder what it's going to look like if I click on art and CG. It might make it look a little bit cooked, which it does. I can do a comparison view of four different AI models. This is standard, art, and CG. Let me go to low res here, and this is the original. So it just takes a moment to update. Art and CG, standard. So the top of the head looks a little bit cooked on art and CG, and a little and less detail here. So overall, standard is the best one usually when you're upscaling images with Gigapixel AI. So overall, it gave some really good results for some real life photos that I took in person. And I'm not even too sure. Actually, no, I did not use a telephoto lens at this time. So that's one of the good reasons to have a really good image upscaler when you can't carry around or you don't have a telephoto lens. And anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe and follow me on Instagram. Until the next video, have a good one.